And I'm Anne Marie Green.
And I'm Vladimir Dutiev. Former White House counsel Don McGahn has defied Congress by skipping a major congressional hearing. Now, the House Judiciary Committee is threatening to force McGahn to testify on the Mueller report in court.
McGahn is considered a key player in the special counsel's investigation, and House Democrats want answers on President Trump potentially obstructing justice.
This committee will hear Mr. McGahn's testimony, even if we have to go to court to secure it. We will not allow the president to prevent the American people from hearing from this witness. We will not allow the president to block congressional subpoenas, putting himself and his allies above the law. We will not allow the president to stop this investigation, and nothing in these unjustified and unjustifiable legal attacks will stop us from pressing forward with our work on behalf of the American people. We will hold this president accountable, one way or the other.
Well, earlier we spoke with CBS News Chief Congressional Correspondent Nancy Cordes about the latest developments.
Well, I thought that the chairman, Jerry Nadler, really encapsulated the Democratic argument in his opening statement where he said, and I'm paraphrasing, that the president told McGahn to commit crimes on his behalf and lie about it. And then he told McGahn not to come here today so that Congress could ask him about it. So that, in a nutshell, is really what has Democrats so infuriated. They think that there was one instance of obstruction of justice during the Mueller investigation, and there's another one taking place in real time right now. Then you heard from the top Republican on the committee, Doug Collins of Georgia, and he said that basically Democrats have sour grapes and that the Mueller report didn't give them anything to satisfy their base. There were no charges, so now they're trying to drum up controversy wherever they can find it and try to go out after the president in other ways. So that is really the dividing line here. And as we expected, this hearing appears to be coming to a close fairly quickly after hearing from only the chairman and the ranking Republican. But what's going to continue and what has been really fascinating to watch over the past 12 to 24 hours is this shift, very marked shift among members of the House Democratic Caucus, where you have Democrats who have never before said that they favor impeachment proceedings now, saying, well, actually, given the stonewalling by the Trump administration, given the fact that the president himself is saying that he does not want anyone who works for him to cooperate with congressional subpoenas, you have Democrats for the first time now saying that they do believe that perhaps that their party should initiate impeachment proceedings here in the House, at the very least so that they can strengthen their investigatory hand and get their hands on some of these documents that the Trump administration is denying them right now.
Well, we're watching, Nancy. Our viewers are seeing Representative Collins and Chairman Nadler having an animated discussion, and there appears to be some smiles. There appears to be a little animation of the hands. We don't know what they're saying, but you heard from Collins, and it's basically a refrain that we've heard from the White House, that that he believes that the House, the Democrats, are overstepping their bounds here in their attempt to either try to impeach the president or to try to relitigate the 2016 election.
And that the Mueller report is the final word.
Is the final word.
Right, but you know, Democrats have a little extra wind in their sails today because even as they are frustrated by the fact that McGahn didn't show up here, they won a pretty significant victory in federal court yesterday. A federal judge ruling for the first time in this ongoing fight between the White House and House Democrats. And in that case, the judge ruled that Democrats do have a right to go after the president's financial records, do have a right to investigate that. The president's lawyers had been arguing that this is that Congress doesn't have any right to these records from before the president even took office, that Democrats are simply trying to embarrass the president, and that these are personal documents and should remain so. The federal judge said, if Democrats believe that there is a potential crime that has been committed, then they are within their rights to investigate. And he ruled in their favor. And there are a number of other cases that are going to be coming down the pike. And Democrats saw this as a very important litmus test. And they feel that it shows that they've got the stronger legal argument forward.
All right, Nancy Cordes for us. A little fewer hours than the last time around, Nancy. Thank you so much for being a part of this with us. We appreciate it as always.
You're welcome.